Hi there, thanks for joining us. Today I'm speaking with Cameron Gleeson. He is a senior investment strategist in BetaShares, and we're going to have a chat about how ETFs might be used in the construction of a diversified portfolio. Cam, good to talk to you.
Tom, great to be here.
Now, when it comes to ETFs, you know, I think what stands out is how easily you can build exposure to any number of things that you want to invest in, but you can do it cheaply and in a way that's quite transparent. Is that sum it up?
I think so. I look at ETFs as really useful building blocks for your portfolio. And I think there's four key characteristics. The first one is ease of access to really, you know, exciting investment exposures that aren't necessarily available in Australia. The second is low-cost diversified investing. We know that's important for generating wealth over time. The third is transparency, being able to look through your ETF and understand what's sitting within that investment. And the fourth is that ease of access point, being able to buy an ETF in a single trade on the ASX through your CompSec account.
Well, let's talk about the last one first, ease. Now, you tune into the news, you see someone carping on about what's gone on in the share market, and you think, you know, how do I get a slice of that action? And the ease with which you can basically get the ASX 200 into your portfolio through an ETF is the starting point, I suppose, isn't it?
I think so. Yeah. So there are one of the great advantages is that the ease of basically buying a diversified investment in one trade and being incredibly low cost. Our A200 ETF is the lowest cost Australian shares ETF available. So the management fee on that is an annual fee that comes out of the performance of the fund, is 0.04% per annum. Incredibly low cost way of getting exposure to that whole 200 companies in one trade. Yep. Fantastic place to start.
So access, right? It's not just a matter of being able to invest in the ASX 200. You can invest in foreign markets. You can invest in foreign markets with specific themes. That is really important and far easier than what it would have been, say, even 10 years ago.
That's right. That's right. And, you know, the benefits of investing offshore outside of Australia are really strong. If we look at the performance of the Australian equity market last year versus global equity markets, the Australian equity market outperformed. You know, great year in terms of commodity prices and the like. But this year, it's actually gone into reverse. So the Australian market's underperformed global shares. So a way to build that diversification is pulling in those global exposures that aren't available in Australia. And, you know, there's some great examples of companies and reasons why you might look to do that. Like if we look at BHP, you know, great company, global leader, but a very cyclical company. Its revenues today, they've grown strongly, but they're still below where they were 10 years ago because of the cyclicality of that business. Microsoft, on the other hand, you know, a global leader, its revenues have just continued to compound over time. So blending different types of exposures, bringing the best of global to your Australian equities is a great way to start.
Now, the one thing that is very important for a younger investor when they're starting out is not to have your returns eaten into by costly investments. So an ETF solves for that as well, doesn't it?
It does, that's right. And you know, whether or not you want to build your portfolio, your equities or core of your portfolio out of those low-cost Australian and global building blocks, or as a young investor, you might choose to buy a all-in-one diversified ETF that will give you a exposure to both Australian and global shares. So, for example, our diversified all-growth ETF, DHHF, gives you a portfolio of over 8,000 shares in a single trade, diversified across Australian global markets. Great way to start if you you're just starting on that investment journey.
So I suppose, you know, just to explain the obvious, in the old days, if you wanted to build that portfolio yourself, you'd have to go and, you know, buy all of those shares, all of those individual transactions would have been very costly. Mm. The fact that it's all packaged up in one neat place is what allows you to get that at such a low price.
That's right. That's right. And it allows you to either, you know, concentrate on other ways to add value to your portfolio or frankly, just get on with your life.
Indeed. So the other one, which I suppose this dovetails into, is transparency. So all of those things are nicely compartmentalized in one place with a bow tied around them, and you can easily have a look under the bonnet and what's going on.
That's right. So index tracking ETFs are quite special in some sense in that ETF providers, if you go to the fund website, you'll be able to see the holdings of that ETF, the proportions to which the ETF is allocated to various stocks, updated on a daily basis. Now, that can be really important if I'm building a core portfolio of ETFs and I want to buy some individual stocks. You know, what's the overlap between my holding of, for example, NVIDIA within my ETFs and my, you know, potential, you know, if I'm looking to buy NVIDIA outside of an ETF.
Yeah.
So that's really critical for understanding both performance, what's driving returns, but also, you know, ensuring that I don't have overlaps that I don't want to have.
So I suppose the other point that you've hinted at as well is that, you know, depending on where you are in an economic cycle, there might be a whole load of different things happening. You want to invest in one thing, but you don't want to, you know, have any exposure to other things. That's a really important feature of ETFs, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. There is a wide range of ETFs available on the ASX. So you get choice. You have the ability to compare different funds. Again, having that transparency and that look through enables you to do so in a manner that, you know, before the launch of ETFs, frankly, just wasn't available.
Let's quickly talk about thematic ETFs, because that's where it all comes down to a fine point. You know, again, you're reading the newspaper. People don't do that anymore, I suppose. You know, you're reading something on a website that tells you about all the themes in investing at the moment. Decarbonization, you've got the electrification of the global car fleet, you've got AI, there are any number of things that are important from an investment standpoint at the moment, and ETFs have got a solution that is all custom made for those themes.
That's right. This is where the ETF package has really worked really effectively to provide specific exposures to themes such as robotics and artificial intelligence. So for example, our RBTZ fund gives you exposure to a diversified basket of companies that are leading the charge in that space. And I talked about NVIDIA before, but say, for example, C3 AI and some of the leading industrial robotics companies that are leveraging AI in their product suite. We can also talk about the energy transition, and there's a lot of talk in the news about what that means for critical minerals.
Yep.
So you can get a diversified exposure to miners and producers of a range of critical minerals through an ETF, for example, XMET, that gives you that. So that just great ways of playing particular themes that you believe have long-term potential.
Cam, some really good pointers there on the fundamentals of how to build a portfolio using ETFs. Thanks very much for your time.
My pleasure, Tom.
And thanks for joining us for the Executive Series.